when I was in at the USC film scoring program, Chris Young was absolutely the rock star teacher. He had huge movies out at the time, and we all had no idea how he was making time to teach.
I just don't see how he can also continue to give anybody who shows up and needs help as a composer, he'll make the time for him. That's truly amazing.
Chris would come in and he would bang on the piano, and it would always be like, and then there's the woodwinds are going to go, blah, and then the bottom's going to go, blah, and then the top's going to go, blah, blah, da, 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 da.
Something. One of the best things that Chris has ever relayed to any of us as musicians is that all of us have a place. There's no shortage of composers, there's no shortage of work, there's no shortage of creativity, and that we all have a chance to make it.
From the get-go as a student, I felt the fact that he was supportive. He wanted us all to succeed.
He just provided this environment where he was just so human and so real and so capable of making mistakes.
He put his phone number up on the chalkboard for all to see. And he said, any of you guys want to call me, ask me any questions, whatever, you know, there's my number, just call.
He really feels strongly about imparting the knowledge to people and making it almost like a joint learning experience.
Aside from all the stress, aside from all the workloads, aside from all the hecticness of what he does and the business that we're in, deep down, he is one of the warmest, nicest people that I know in this business.
This guy just scored Spider-Man 3, and he's like willing to do this tiny little movie for us for, you know, no money. I'm always blown away by that. And it just continued. I mean, that was just his personality. That's just who he is. He has a heart, you know, and they say that's hard to find in Hollywood.
Chris would invite his class from USC over to the office, a couple of days away from a recording session, and spent 4 hours sometimes, went back to his room and finished the score, and always did.
When I first got the phone call about becoming a board member at ETM, the first thing I saw was Chris's name on the list. First of all, I know this has got to be good, and I knew it's got to be something that's worthwhile, because that's what he does. This makes a difference. And for an organization like ETM to be able to get people like Chris Young and the rest of us involved, and then have our passion translate to try to bring back music into these schools that desperately need it, for the kids, they won't know they're missing it, but they are. And they won't, you know, this is something that's gonna have repercussions 20, 30 years from now. In terms of just even quality of life and the way people's brain develop. One of my favorite quotes from Mr. Hollins was always, you know, if you keep taking away art and music, then sooner or later there's not going to be anything to read or write about.